In the tech war between the US and China, Beijing lags behind on cutting-edge semiconductors, the chips that power everything from smartphones to artificial intelligence.
The barrier to entry is really high because of the cost involved, the concentration in the industry, and also the technical know-how.
Beijing's largest chipmaker, Semiconductor Manufacturing International Corporation, or SMIC, plays a key role in China's push for chip self-sufficiency, but faces significant geopolitical challenges. In 2020, citing national security concerns, the US imposed export restrictions on the company, cutting off access to vital equipment needed to produce the most advanced chips and impacting its ability to close the gap with its larger rivals. But US efforts to keep the company in check appear to have had the opposite effect.
There is a growing awareness in Washington that there is an unintended consequence to the export controls. And this unintended consequence has been that China's been galvanized to create its own self-sufficient semiconductor industry.
SMIC was founded in 2000 by Richard Chang, a Taiwanese-American and a veteran of the chip industry. After studying in the US, Chang worked for American semiconductor giant Texas Instruments. Later, he returned to Taiwan, where he founded Shida Semiconductor, which he then sold to Taiwan's TSMC, the world's most valuable semiconductor company. Chang then went to China, where he started SMIC.
Fast forward to today, you know, it's actually become quite a juggernaut in the space. It's a decent chip foundry, but in terms of the ability to make advanced chips, it's been very constrained. US export controls have made it really, really difficult or impossible to buy the same sort of chip making equipment that allows them to make advanced chips at scale, in bulk, and at a low cost.
Despite these difficulties, analysts believe SMIC is producing chips that can rival those produced by advanced factories in the US and Taiwan, including 7-nanometer chips like those found in Huawei phones last year.
Many people expected SMIC to be unable to make these chips, at least unable to make them in the quantities Huawei needed to sell like a high-end smartphone.
The speed of a chip is determined by how many transistors it contains. The smaller the transistors, which are measured in nanometers, the more can be packed onto a chip, making it more powerful.
An industry teardown revealed that SMIC was the maker of these powerful chips that powered or enabled the smartphone to offer the intelligent capability that it did. So that was really a wake-up call for Washington.
However, SMIC still lags behind, with its two biggest rivals, Taiwan's TSMC and South Korea's Samsung, aiming to produce even more advanced chips.
TSMC and Samsung are now moving on to make 5-nanometer and 3-nanometer chips. SMIC is only at the point where they're making 7-nanometer chips, but in much smaller quantities and not the commercial quantities that China really needs.
But analysts believe that Beijing's ramp-up in production, a drive to produce chips locally, and major government investments will help China catch up.
The last installment of the National Integrated Circuit Fund was $48 billion. And that's money that's pumped in to grow the ecosystem, such as funding talent development programs, funding startups in the space, startups that are working on areas not just chip design, but chip production. There are also startups that are working on making semiconductor manufacturing equipment that China is blocked out from. So all that money is going in and it's helping to build a whole ecosystem domestically that China can tap into in the future when it comes to semiconductors and chips.
In addition, local companies are also waking up to the need for China to be more self-reliant.
A lot of Chinese companies also saw the writing on the wall. So instead of just being a top-down effort by the Chinese government to push the localization of the industry and push companies to use SMIC and not TSMC, Chinese companies decided that maybe we should divvy up a portion of our orders and pass it to a local company, just in case we were cut off from Taiwanese foundries like TSMC or cut off from overseas chip makers.
After imposing retaliatory tariffs on US goods last month, China also issued new rules on determining the origin of semiconductor imports. Some analysts believe this move could give domestic chip makers like SMIC an advantage in gaining market share over its US rivals. What's more, a recent U.S. Senate committee hearing saw top players in the AI industry speak out on the looming threat of China's technological advancements.
As a matter of economic security, as a matter of national security, America has to beat China in the AI race.
China's a really innovative country, and the fact of the matter is they're making inroads in aspects such as EVs, rechargeable batteries, AI. It's much more difficult to make the same strides very quickly in chips. That said, the fact that China has made so much inroads and so many strides in such short a time really shows me that, you know, China shouldn't be taken for granted, and in a couple of years could be as formidable as some of the Western rivals.